They are not like the children who play in the streets and gardens. For them, all the seasons are the same. There is no difference between spring and winter, summer and autumn.
Ye who sing creation's story, now proclaim Messiah's birth.
He is an innocent child whose childhood dreams were shattered prematurely. It seems that hope is gone from his eyes, and that for him life offers no way forward. His situation represents the suffering of all those children who have to face the severity of life, whose greatest challenge is to be alive and fight for survival. Christmas renews the hope of these children and the wishes of all the children with special needs. Why shouldn't it be like this? For Christ was born in a humble cave, bringing the light of salvation to all men. Do we respect the disabled and the sick? They were created in God's image, and their disability does not erase this fact. They possess the same dignity as other people. The disabled do not need our pity, they need our love. I want to add one more thing. Those who behave with respect and dignity with the disabled and the elderly will receive grace in their presence. The house that takes care of the sick will be blessed and receive a hundredfold. He is always smiling. He smiles wherever his feet take him. He smiles to the whole world, whether the world smiles at him or holds a grudge. He walks toward you with eager simplicity and starts a conversation even if he does not know you. His vocabulary knows no expressions of anger or hate. When he speaks, often with great difficulty, the words come out of his mouth with spontaneity and sincerity. They are authentic and not false. He has an extra chromosome, and this is what distinguishes him from us, normal people. It's a chromosome of innocence, a quality which is slowly being replaced in our world by malice and hatred. But this little angel embodies the hymn of charity, as St. Paul said in his letter to the Corinthians. In charity, miracles are wrought, and in charity, the impossible is achieved. Thank you.